5 rounds to go with no score. I don't see the
charge in that round. I just can't quite understand what happened there. Manny Jones still angry. Roberts, on the other hand, glaring at him as if he's never trying to blame me for that. You started it. So maybe Roberts is angrier than he looked at the end of that last round. He's certainly coming in those men's business now. Peter Zarkash, the referee, formerly from Budapest, Hungary, now naturalized British. Side head chance for Roberts. Roberts in the darker. And coming back into it beautifully in his second round. Jones is a little bit slower now, but nicely over the top there, picking up body check to Roberts this time anyway. A lucky climb attempt by Roberts, and the beauty it was. And still coming in for more, another lucky climb. This time Jones over the top of the folding press, and a beauty, the first fall to Marty Jones. In just 1 minute, 31 seconds of round two. And our master of ceremonies, John Harris.
Ladies and gentlemen, the second round, the first fall of the contest goes to Marty Jones.
And a very, very neat fall of points. Took Roberts right by surprise, and Roberts just as he was taking over. But this Marty Jones,
much heavier than his usual light heavyweight limits. But of course, he's had to
soon train down to defend that title of his. The main thing, the crowd really liking this bout, and why shouldn't they? Beautiful wrestling, it's getting a little over the top on certain occasions from early attacks. Cross press to Roberts. Couldn't hold it. But it has been some really fast, agile stuff from both men and heavyweights. Peter Zarkash done very well, been very lenient, only delivered one public warning when I think he should have done a couple more to Jones and several more to Roberts recently. But he's got away with it so far. Roberts, lovely posting, lovely posting by Jones, all the way across. About two of the greatest wrestlers in this country, these boys, in this weight class. Now lifting with the trunks, over the top, takes Boone. Didn't really try to say his own former suplex there, but he hurt him more than even Roberts. Both up. Roberts would have been up if he'd allowed to. Up at eight, and Roberts up finally if he'd allowed to. But still Roberts, worried about that left arm of his, brings the wrist. So it's a double arm now by Roberts, he may be trying a suplex idea. Maybe. On the ropes, outside the ring as well, on the open mirror. And still Roberts has got away with it. Marty Jones saying, all right, if the referee won't help me, I'll see if I can help myself. But not that time. A right back drop and landing on the middle rope with his feet. And the follow down with a full press, but too late. Anyway, the feet right through the ropes. Ultimate round, a couple minutes to go, and still very low, one each. And I would hate hedge a bet on this one. Cross press, Marty Jones. Nearly. Still a touch of cross press. It's okay, she's not lying here, that stuff. Mentioned the breathing, but profits over the top of the top rope there. But he's quite happy to get back in plenty of time. No problem. You won't get in while Jones is standing there. You can hardly blame him. Peter Zakash may be smaller than these two big fellas, but he was a pretty useful welterweight wrestler in the Hungarian wrestling clubs before coming over to this country. And also over here many times we've seen him on television as a welterweight. Much too late tonight. It really served him right though, Pete Roberts. Just under half a minute now in the fifth. Right through the ropes again and attacking illegally on the apron. And still Roberts, no public warning against him. Just 8 seconds now. And one round to go after this one. Second public warning for Marty Jones, a kick after the bell.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee gives Marty Jones his second and final public warning.
Well, that was very stupid of Jones there. Marty Jones of Chadwick from Manchester, and the light heavyweight champion of Great Britain, and doesn't need to resort to moves like that. Two public warnings against him now.
Seconds away for the sixth and final round.
One fall each. Pete Roberts on the right there. Left there, Marty Jones stripped from the waist up. And the lighter pair of tights. It's 5 pounds. Both pretty, if you're watching in the black and white, it's going to be a little tricky unless you can see Marty Jones stripped above the waist. I think it's the best identification point. Round six, one fall each. Two public warnings against Jones. And the next score is the one that matters here for the heavyweight challenge trophy presented by the famous London promoters, Dale Martin. A beautiful trophy of ours. We will see presented by one of these two men. And he was hoping Roberts would follow him up there, but Roberts much too wise for that. And Jones has hurt his wrist. Roberts going for that arm, backhand now. Landing hurt his arm, and Roberts spotted it immediately and went for a backhand. Checking Roberts over the top. And the count by Peter Zakash, very clear, using his fingers as well to sign him in case he can't hit. Roberts producing some well-timed backdrops here, and a flying tackle by Roberts, but he's mistimed it, and it's... a folding press there by Pete Roberts, who's just inside the ropes, and he's done it. 1 minute, 35 seconds into the final round six. Pete Roberts the winner by 2-1 over Marty Jones. And it's Roberts the one who will be presented with that great heavyweight challenge trophy. Your master of ceremonies, John Harris.
And so, ladies and gentlemen, with the deciding fall coming in the final round, the winner by 2-1, the Super Destroyer, Pete Roberts.